Hey there, everybody. It's Kate Beeders, founder of Brilliance Builders and your breakthrough expert. And I want to ask you a really simple question. How often do you feel stressed and overwhelmed? Raise an arm or hand, rather. Yep, I could probably raise both of them, right? It happens to all of us. And especially if you're working on, let's say, a big project or something that's time sensitive, you got to get done. You know, maybe you're doing your taxes or, you know, like me, I just was working on my book, or it could be a new project or anything that you're trying to do. And you tend to get stressed and overwhelmed. So what I wanted to share with you is three ways that you can start to eliminate that. And I'm going to also, what I want to share with you, first of all, is just to tell you that probably most of the stress and overwhelm that I'm referring to in this is something that you kind of are doing yourself. So it's really easy. If you're doing it yourself, then it's easy to switch it. And this is where you sit there and, you know, maybe working on a project or you're writing copy or whatever the heck you're doing. And you're just like, you know, head down to the computer and you're just like, you know, focused and thinking and all that. And, you know, within a couple of hours, your head is just like killing you. Okay. Because maybe it's not coming fast enough, or it's not working well enough, or whatever. If it's like your taxes, you know, maybe you're just getting overwhelmed because you've got all these receipts and slips and all that stuff. So whatever the case might be. So here are three actions for you to take. And the thing you'll find if you're new to listening to my training is that you'll find that what I teach, most of the stuff I teach, is actually fairly easy to implement. It's just a matter that you don't know it yet until I teach you it. And I like things that get results. So let me tell you, the first one is, I'm just going to put my glasses on so I can see, make sure I'm telling you them all. Okay, the first one is you need to take a break at least once every hour. Okay, now what's going to happen is intuitively your mind's going to go, but I can't take a break. That's going to take me off focus. Wrong. By taking a break at least once an hour, you're actually allowing your brain to recharge. And you're only taking like a minute break, right? This, by break, I'm not meaning like when you were a kid and had a part-time job in school and they gave you the 15 minutes or the half hour. That's not what I'm talking about. Just like 1 minute, get up and walk around, dance or something, and then go back. It gives your brain a rest. Because if your brain is so working so hard, that the creativity at a certain point is not going to be happening. So just by giving yourself that simple recharge is going to make all the difference. So that's the first one. The second one I want to share with you is to yawn, okay? And what that is yawning. I'm not going to go into the whole technical neuroscience thing right now, but just quite simply, yawning is a really great way of changing energy. It's one of the fastest ways of doing it. You're just going to go, maybe you stretch and you kind of do those stretches like that, and maybe you stretch your feet. It just feels so good. I know in our society we're brought up yawning is really rude, but you know what? You're here at your desk, or you're at a workspace, or you're in your office, or wherever the heck you might be. Who the heck cares? Just do it. It feels so good. It's another way of just recharging your battery. So that's the second one. The third one is by having like a chime, some kind of bell, can also start and to help recharge your brain. So I'm just, so something like this, just go like that. And just hearing something like that can recharge your brain. Now, I know a lot of you are not going to go out and buy a bowl. I don't expect you to, but you know what? There are so many different online apps that you can have. Some of the phones, even for their alarm systems, have like chimes. So there's a lot of different ways to kind of get around that. You don't necessarily have to go out and buy a bowl unless you're so inclined. So this is, again, these are three ways to help you deal with stress and overwhelm. All right, the first one is, remember, get up, take a break at least once every hour, at least once every hour, short little break, okay? Second is to yawn. And third is to ring a bell or chime, or hear a bell or chime, set it on a timer. So this is so critical to know, because if you are stressed and overwhelmed, you'll never accomplish all you want to do. And plus, you'll be so miserable the whole time. And what's the point of that? The point is to enjoy the journey. And if you're always stressed out and overwhelmed, you are not enjoying your journey. So that's the message I have for you today. And if I can help you further and you're looking to hire a coach, a mentor, please reach out to my team, info@katebeeders.com. That's info@katebeeders.com. The reason they call me the breakthrough expert is I'm known for getting people really amazing results. And if that's you, let me hear from you.